The Chinese nation, with its civilization dating back over 5,000 years, has made numerous contributions to humankind. From the mid-19th century, however, for 100 years, she endured unprecedented suffering. So many times, the Chinese nation rose up to fight, only to meet with failure. The humiliation reached a new height in 1919 at the Paris Peace Conference, when victorious China was treated like a defeated country. And finally, the Chinese nation's rage blew up like an erupting volcano.
This sketch is based on the recent highly popular TV drama series Age of Awakening. The founding members of the Communist Party of China, among them Li Dazhao and Chen Duxiu, in 1921 established a new party rooted in Marxism that would represent the people and guided China to a new dawn.
过上好日子, 他是中国美好未来的先生。
任之先生, 写得太好了。
毛泽东,
天下者,
another early member, led the party and people in the revolution that culminated in the founding of the People's Republic of China in 1949. Early leading communists Chen Wangdao and Qu Qiubai translated the first Chinese version of the Communist Manifesto and the song The Internationale, respectively, to inspire the Chinese people in their fight for a better life.
Qiubai先生,这就是您翻译的国际歌。起来!
饥寒交迫的奴隶，起来！全世界受苦的人，要为中国寻找一条光明之路，那就一起唱响这首《全世界无产阶级革命者的》。
战歌。
The Communist Party of China was founded. This was an epoch-making event. Immediately, the CPC began exploring a new revolutionary path for integrating Marxism-Leninism with China's reality. However, in 1927, the Kuomintang turned their knives against the Communists. This treachery taught the fledgling CPC a bloody lesson, that it would have to be reborn from fire. The flames of idealism and belief, once ignited, would never be extinguished.
Facing the white terror unleashed by the Kuomintang, the revolutionaries risked death in order to awaken the nation. Chen Yannian, the son of Chen Duxiu, chose to die rather than beg for his life. Poet Xia Minghan expressed his faith in communism in the famous verse, "Die for my beliefs."
歌同志歌
会议，在红军第五次反围剿失败和长征。
The historic Zunyi Conference was convened at a time when the Red Army's counterattack against the Kuomintang's fifth encirclement had failed, and the Long March was encountering severe difficulties in its early stages. The meeting reaffirmed Marxism as represented by a leadership corps, including Mao Zedong, as the correct way ahead for the Communist Party of China. Thus, the first generation of the CPC's collective leadership with Mao Zedong as the core was formed, and the party entered a new stage of independently solving the problems facing the Chinese Revolution. At a critical moment, the Zunyi Conference saved the party, the Red Army, and the Chinese Revolution.
挽救了党，挽救了红军，挽救了中国革命。
望的日子快点到来。
Martyrs 江竹君、李白和董存瑞 all fought for communism to the last, all lost their lives just before the hopeful dawn arrived. But their example encouraged others to follow in their footsteps and work to build a new China where people could lead a better life.
为了新中国，前进！
For 28 years, the Communist Party of China had been undaunted and tenacious on the battlefield. With an iron will, it endured numerous hardships. But having shattered the old world, could the CPC build a new one? In 1949, a new People's Republic was about to be born in the East.
一个崭新的人民共和国在世界东方诞生。
In 1952, during the Battle of the Shangganling Mountains in the Korean War, a young Chinese soldier wrote a letter to his mother. He told her proudly that while on the front line, he had joined the Communist Party of China. In the letter, he pledged to both his mother and his country that no enemy would pass their position. The battle, known in the West as the Battle of Triangle Hill, was one of the bloodiest, most documented during the entire Korean War.
Peace.
The 1960s was a period of great fervor in China as the nation came together to build a socialist country under the leadership of Mao Zedong. There emerged numerous heroes, soldiers and ordinary workers, scientists and grassroots officials, such as oil worker Wang Jinxi, who earned the nickname Iron Man with his unyielding spirit. Lei Feng, a soldier who always served the people, but died at 22 in an accident. Qian Xuesen, a scientist who is regarded as the father of China's space technology. And local officials like Jiao Yulu and Shi Laihe, who devoted themselves to making life better for the people.
The socialist revolution in construction brought about the most profound social change in the history of the country. It laid the foundation for the great progress and development achieved by New China. Could the Communist Party, having liberated the Chinese people, bring them prosperity? Could China advance sufficiently to catch up with the times? In 1978, at the third plenary session of the 11th CPC Central Committee, reform and opening up were presented as the historic answer to these questions. An epic journey of reform and opening up and socialist modernization had begun.
诚的心，只有心路人最理解心路人，脚下的路越长，心中的爱越深。
我们从夜从夜走到了长，我们
It's dawn on the day of Hong Kong's return to the motherland, and the People's Liberation Army Hong Kong Garrison is taking over responsibility for safeguarding the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region.
Thank you.
Across China, Communist Party members are leading the way in some of the great infrastructure projects of the day. Their selfless devotion ensures that water and electricity, gas and coal that are vital to people's livelihood can be supplied, sometimes across enormous distances. For them, their shared identity as party members is a source of great pride.
我是一方天然气，在万里国脉中穿峡谷越山岗，气势高昂。我是一度光明电，在万丈天际上攀高原走平川，编织成网。我是一滴甘甜水，在万道通衢间跨江河连湖泊奔流逐浪。我是一块动力煤，在万路专线里京城市郭村庄温暖八方。
我奋斗，我是共产党员，一身风沙换清洁能源，让万水千山交响。我幸福，我是共产党员，一手老茧换不竭电流，将万家灯火点亮。我奉献，我是共产党员。
一双泥腿换汩汩清泉，把万户心田滋养。我自豪，我是共产党员。一心向往，换炽热动能聚万民磅礴力量。
气之力，电之能，水之勇，煤之热，全中国一盘棋。
有你的家乡，也有我的家乡，遍地英雄抗金朝，沧海日出更妖娆，东西南北纵横联动，万里征途荡气飘扬。
Having exited his capsule, Chinese astronaut Zhai Zhigang sent greetings to China and the world. Following the 18th CPC National Congress in 2012, socialism with Chinese characteristics entered a new era. Under the CPC's leadership and in step with the great rejuvenation of the Chinese nation, the Chinese people have achieved independence, prosperity, and strength. The country is the people, and the people are the country. To meet the people's desire for a better life is what the party is striving for. At the time when the CPC is celebrating its 100th anniversary, the country has achieved victory in the efforts to eradicate absolute poverty and build a moderately prosperous society.
县福建人民把我们建省台小镇了。密宁镇是福建跟宁夏东西协作扶贫的典范了。
This sketch highlights the achievements of China's poverty alleviation drive. Mining, a town in the northwestern Ningxia region, is a major beneficiary of the campaign. Back in the 1990s, the government's East-West Pairing Up program saw the prosperous coastal Fujian province help backwater Ningxia. This led to the creation of a brand new town, Mining,where today some 9,000 once poor families are enjoying a better life.
Nestled among lush mountains in central China's Hunan province is a village called Shibadong. It was here that in 2013 the idea of targeted poverty alleviation was first suggested.The main principle is that poverty alleviation would be most effective if measures were devised that were tailored to the specific local conditions.
The Communist Party of China has fulfilled its promise to eradicate poverty by 2020. The endeavor saw Xi Jinping visit every one of the 14 most impoverished areas across China. Here, representatives from these 14 areas express their gratitude and look forward to the countryside revitalization program, bringing them greater prosperity.
感谢党，我们过上好日子啦！
大礼花。 新世界下。
今天，我的祖国进入了中国特色社会主义新时代，如同一幅宏伟壮丽的画卷，向世界磅礴展开。
As China looks to the future and continues to improve the life of the people, it's promoting scientific research. The country is already at the forefront of development in many fields. Space and deep sea exploration, aircraft manufacturing, road, rail and sea transport, and 5G communication. All these endeavors are leading to the fulfillment of the Chinese dream.
Thank you. 唐天元、刘伯明。
唐天元、唐洪波。
From China's space station 400 kilometers above the Earth, Shenzhou 12 astronauts Lie Haisheng, Liu Boming, and Tang Hongbo extend greetings to the Communist Party of China on its centenary.
The flag of the Communist Party of China bears a hammer and a sickle, symbolizing the workers and farmers. It has served as a banner held high by the party throughout its history, and still today, as it leads the country to its great rejuvenation.
This is a transition.
中国共产党为我们领航，向着中华民族伟大复兴的目标，
向着实现共产主义远大理想乘风破浪，
让我们紧密团结在以习近平同志为核心的党中央周围，向社会主义现代化国家高歌猛进，
领航！
伟大的中国共产党，
领航！伟大的中国共产党，
齐唱歌曲，没有共产党就没有新中国。